Today on Capitol Hill, angry lawmakers insisting it is not President Obama's job to change the laws that Congress passes. Just a short time ago, the House passing 233 to 181, Representative Trey Gowdy's Enforce the Law Act. It would allow the House or Senate to sue President Obama or any president or other executive branch members for failing to enforce the law. So what led Republican lawmakers to take this action? Representative Gowdy joins us. And before we get to that question, in looking through the things that you said on the floor, I suspect that Senator Obama, not President Obama, Senator Obama would have voted for this from what he said.
He would have. I think the most illustrative quote was when he blamed the Supreme Court for this balance of power getting out of whack. He specifically blamed the Chief Justice as Senator Obama. And, you know, you hate to use the word duplicity, but when you change your position based solely on what your title is, it either leads me to believe it wasn't a deeply held conviction in the first place, or maybe you're engaging in a little bit of duplicity.
All right. So what's sort of the beginning of this is that health care was passed by Congress, went to the president for his signature, and it's your position that he is basically legislating when he gives waivers or gives delays in certain portions or doesn't enforce them, that he's writing the law and he doesn't have the authority, and you can't challenge him now unless your law gets passed.
Well, there are penalties. The purse, you can withhold money, but then you're hurting innocent people when you're playing an appropriations game. Impeachment is a penalty, but if you're looking for a remedy, not a penalty, you need to enforce the law that we passed. The Affordable Care Act is a great example. Mandatory minimums is the example I use the most. I mean, you may not like mandatory minimums. I personally don't like them in drug cases, but it's the law. And Holder announced wholesale, we're no longer going to notify the judges what the drug amounts are.
So when a president doesn't enforce the law as written by Congress, but sort of enforces some of it or not all of it, how do you want to challenge it? What does your law do?
Well, we want standing, which is a big hurdle to overcome.
Which means ability.
The ability to even go to court to seek redress. And we want the judicial branch to order the executive branch to execute the law. And there's a great example of that happening in a case called N. Ray Aiken. I won't go into the legal part of it, but the Nuclear Regulatory Commission refuses to act on Yucca Mountain. So a county in South Carolina went to court and said, will you please make the executive branch do what Congress has required them to do? And the D.C. Court of Appeals issued a mandamus ordering them to follow the law.
All right. So if your law passes, either the House or the Senate could seek to have the president enforce the law as written. Your law has to go to the Senate.
Yes, ma'am.
It's dead on arrival there.
Well, I didn't think five Democrats would vote for it today. I think with the current constitution of the Senate, it probably is on life support. But the great thing about our framers is we have a chance to change out 33 or 34 of the senators every 2 years. And my guess is this would be a 70 or 80% polling issue. Do you think the executive branch should have to faithfully execute the law?
And chances are, if there were a Republican president, there'd be a lot more Democrats who would like this idea.
They went nuts with President Bush. They
I know, it's always nuts. That way. That's Washington. Anyway, Congressman, always nice to see you.
Yes, ma'am.
And straight ahead, you're expecting